Okay, today we're going to fix a toilet fill valve. We've got a problem with this little character right here. Get some light on it. So this thing here has not been working very well. It fills up really slow. So I'm going to replace it today. Now I could have called a plumber, which would have cost $100 for the guy to come out, and then he would have probably charged me another $100 for the part. This part right here you can buy at Home Depot for $8. And that's the part that we're gonna change right here. First thing you gotta do is come down here, find your shutoff valve, and close it. Now once we got that closed, we're gonna come up here. We're just gonna empty the top tank of water. As you can see, water's flowing out. But we need to get all of it out of there. So, we're going to do it again. We're going to press that down again. And there we go. Now, you don't need a whole bunch of tools. If you look under here, you're going to see that it's got a little easy little turn thing that you just unscrew. What I've done is I put a little bucket down here to catch the excess water that's gonna come out of here. That way you don't flood your whole bathroom. So then you just kinda unhook this by just turning it. As you can see, you're gonna get water coming out. Hopefully I turned it off okay. I'll know in a minute. All right, so I think we're okay there. This thing looks like it's good. Now what we gotta do is we gotta twist this off, which is a pretty simple procedure. Just roll it like that. Comes right off. Now I can pull the toilet fill valve out, and you're gonna need this, so don't lose it. Hang on to that. Gonna get some drippage. Let me go up in here. We're gonna look down there. You're gonna see it's got a little bit of stoppage on it, but we're gonna have to make sure that we do that. And as you can see, the reason why you want that little deal there so that you don't spill everything everywhere. When I popped this out, of course, all the excess water ran out that hole into my bucket down there. So make sure you got a bucket under there so you don't get everything wet. Okay, so we got our parts here. This little baby has to go down in that little hole, and that makes the seal so that it doesn't leak. So that's going to go right down in there. It's going to be pressed up on here, and we're going to do that next. All right, so I've pushed our rubber gasket on here. You can see. Then I'm going to slip it down through the hole. Now that should give us a good seal. But you can see it's a little low, so you can adjust this. This has an adjustment on it. I'm just going to measure the new one, even with the old one, and then shove it through on the bottom. And to do that, all you do is kind of just screw it out. So we're almost pretty even there, don't you think? So now we're ready to go. All right, so now I've got our little rubber stopper on there. I'm gonna smush it down in there. Next thing is I gotta come down underneath. And I gotta put this piece right here back up on there. So I'm just gonna kind of roll it, just nice and easy. You see there's a little water coming through. And that's just going to go up. It's going to tighten like a son of a gun. And we just squish it. All we do is, all you do is turn it with your fingers. You don't need a special device or nothing. It just gets nice and tight. Nice and tight. I'll turn it with my fingers. That's it. And then I'm going to take this, put it right on there. Then I just screw that right back up on. And once it's on there,
Ready to go. Nice and tight. Now, if I turn the water on, we're gonna know if we got a leak. So let's try it.
So I'm gonna take a gander here. I've gotta put our little deal right there so it runs into this thing. So I think I've got a little, as you see, there's a little, see if you can see it. There's a little nipple here. I'm gonna put a little hose that's gonna run over to this pipe here and set inside, just like it was before. And instead of using this one that they gave me, I'm just gonna pull this old one off of here because it's the perfect length and just put it on the new one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use this one. Just push it right on the nipple. And then this thing's gonna slide right on there like that. It's a little bit cracked, but that's all right. It should still work. All right, now the question is, when I turn the water on, will it leak? And that's what we're hoping, that we got it a tight enough seal that we're not gonna flood the house, because toilets are the worst. They flood the house. They flood your house so easily. They get plugged up or something like this, and this thing's not working. Bam, the next thing you know, you get a horrible flood. So you gotta keep your eye on it. And then we're gonna fix this chain thing in a minute. All right, now I'm gonna go underneath the toilet, I'm gonna turn the water on, and we're gonna see what happens. Cross your fingers. Apparently, it's filling up. And if I look down here, I don't see any leakage. So let's watch and see how it goes. So far, so good. As you can see, I have to use this damn flashlight because we don't have enough light in our house. Now that stopper ball should come up, and then it should turn the valve down there, closing the water coming into the water closet. This top part of the tank is called the water closet. That holds all of your water that flushes your toilet. It works on a gravity. So look at that. Coming up. Coming up. Cross your fingers. Hopefully it works. It sucks to have all that water everywhere. Oh, hey. It looks like we have success. So now let's try flushing it and see what happens. Down it goes. Immediately it starts squirting, which it should. That's kind of waste water, but as you can see, it's closed already. And there's still half the water inside the cabinets, the water closet itself. So I think we're okay. Now we got to look underneath. I decided to change out this hose because this is much quieter, as you can hear. Much better way to go. And it looks like we're pretty good. I don't see any water here, not one drip, and that's what you're looking for. As you can see, this thing did fill up because I had a little bit of runoff, because this valve is so freaking old, but it still works, so we should be good.